Hi, and welcome to the 12th video about our DevSecOps pipeline, which we are building with GitHub. With this video, we will conclude our video series about GitHub. So this video is all about our recommendation and our summary on GitHub. Hey, Paddy. In our past 11 video, what have we done so far with GitHub and the DevSecOps pipeline?
If you already followed us, you learned that we started with a general introduction over the whole pipeline and the platform. We then introduced software composition analysis, license compliance, static application security testing, container scanning, secret detection. We went forward and did dynamic application security testing, as well as merge requests and how they integrate into the platform and the security tools. And finally, we did sessions about scheduled pipelines and vulnerability management with the features the platform provides. So make sure that you check back the other episodes of this video series if you need more details about what follows.
So, Paddy, what are our recommendations when it comes to building a DevSecOps pipeline with GitHub?
Let's see. When it comes to structuring your pipelines, we think it's best to create top-level workflows that use simpler workflows that do specific, simple jobs, and then orchestrate the simpler jobs into bigger workflows, as mentioned, so that it's easier to maintain over time. What I mean with this is create workflows like main pipeline here and include for each job a sub pipeline or sub action like build, SCA, SAST, and so on. If you check back, you'll find them here, SAST, build, and so on.
So the next point is that you need to define on what branch you want to run which pipeline. You even can have different pipelines for your different branches. And of course, as you could also see in our videos, you need to schedule your pipeline, and there you need to define on which branch the scheduled pipeline runs. You need to schedule your pipelines because you already have a version of your application in production. And because of that, and because you're not always changing things in your pipeline, the pipeline will not run on the productive code. This is why it is important to have a scheduled pipeline. Check our video about scheduled pipeline to get more information how to do that. Setting the default branch in GitHub is very easy. You go to settings, and then in general, you see the default branch, and here you can define it.
Another thing that works great for us is using pull requests to find newly introduced security issues. This will also require you to define a process to review and maybe require approval if you find new critical vulnerabilities during a pull request.
Talking about pull requests, it is essential that you are protecting your main branch. For that, you can use branch protection rules. This would also be our recommendation to you to configure that. Let's have a look how you do that. We are back here in GitHub. We go to settings, and then we have here branches, and here you can already see our branch protection rule, which we have defined. When you click here on edit, you can define on what branch it is applied. In our case, it's star. Star means on all branches. And then here you can define your protection rules for all of your branches.
And very important if you're actually working in confidential projects or enterprise projects is to security review the tools you source from the marketplace. Be aware that whatever you pull in from a marketplace is just community provided code, and you need to make sure that it is sufficiently secure to use within your environment. This usually means that you need to review the source and maybe, best case, import it into your own repositories and manage it from there.
Secret management is really an essential part when you are developing a DevSecOps pipeline. Therefore, our recommendation to you is to use the GitHub secret store for managing your secrets. When you want to have an even better solution than the GitHub secret store, then you can use the Azure Key Vault as your secret store. The Azure Key Vault is very well integrated and you have advanced management capability when using the Azure Key Vault. Of course, you can use also other Key Vaults, but the integration of Azure Key Vault is really outstanding.
Because GitHub doesn't provide a default set of security tools, you're forced to evaluate what security tools work for you. If you're looking for potential candidates, check back our episodes of this video series and you'll find potential candidates for you. When it comes to including DAST, Dynamic Application Security Testing, also known as Automated Penetration Testing, then make sure you customize the scanner configuration well. If you don't customize your DAST solution, then the benefit is very limited.
Vulnerability management is really an essential part when you are developing a DevSecOps pipeline. You could see in our videos that even with a simple Java project, you get quite a lot of vulnerability findings. Managing these findings is an essential part when you have a DevSecOps pipeline. The vulnerability management of GitHub is okay, you can work with that, but we identified a huge gap when it comes to create your own vulnerability findings. At the moment, you are not able to add your own vulnerability findings, create a new one, which you potentially have found during a penetration test. This limits the use of the vulnerability management of GitHub, and our recommendation would be to use an external vulnerability management, unfortunately. You could see during our videos that you will have quite a lot of security findings and you also need to configure all of the security tools. Because of that, our recommendation is clearly to add a security expert to your team so that you can configure the tools correctly and that you also can make sense out of all of these security findings which you will have.
And with that, this concludes our video series about GitHub DevSecOps pipelines. If you're also interested in GitLab, then make sure you check our video series about GitLab. And if you're interested in a comparison of these two platforms, then fast forward to the future and take a look at our video about our recommendations and the comparison between GitLab and GitHub. So thank you very much for watching this video and maybe the whole video series. Goodbye.